Hey, this is Michael from Viral Home-Based Pursuits, and I want to go over my review of Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki. And this book right here is it's an understatement to say that it's life-changing, but it has really changed my mindsets, and it has changed my approach to my business, approach to life in general, okay? Gives you a whole different view on life. The book on the outside here, you can see Robert. And it says here, celebrating 20 years as a number one personal finance book of all time. And it's really true. Once you go into this, it opens your eyes about everything. It's a nice little cover. And, you know, it's about 290 or so pages with more on the back, actually. So over 300 extra stuff. But and then you can see I have my notes here. I've already finished it. I just kind of go through this and do like page 234, what I learned here. This book is really going to ensure that you stay on top of not only learning it, but taking action. It's going to go through, at the end of every chapter, it goes over a summary. It goes over what you learned. It's going to go over what, things like, you know, it's going to ask you, it's going to go over the summary first. It's going to go over, like, this is what you learned in this chapter, and then it's going to go also over questions to ask yourself in each and every single one of them here. And Robert really goes into depth in the beginning, talks about his story and how much of an impact it made on having his rich dad, who was more so self-educated, knew a lot about finances and personal finance, right? And was financially literate, which has helped them out in life. And then his poor dad, who's not necessarily like poor, but he's very educated and has that educated mindset where it's like, get a job, you know, get your 401k benefits, pay your taxes, pay the government, you know, spend what you want, how you want, you know. And then really opens up your eyes, because I come from that middle class. It talks about middle class, poor class, and then it also talks about the rich, or the high income, the higher class and the rich, the levels of it. And, you know, coming from a middle class family, you know, I was always taught to go to school. I did. I went to school. I went to college. Done 3.5 years thus far, university and community. And, you know, I grew up that way. I grew up in the school system. I grew up, you know, playing as a Division I soccer athlete, and then also going to school, get a job and do that. That's what I did. And until I read this and I took a different route, it opened my eyes on everything, guys. You need to read this. I can't even. Here, let me just look for a spot in here. As a young boy, my educated dad encouraged me to find a safe job. My rich dad encouraged me to begin acquiring assets that I love. If you don't love it, you won't take care of it. And then Robert also goes into the cash flow game, how that works. Kind of like Monopoly when you were younger. Or if you're, you know, still in that stage where you're learning about Monopoly. How debt works and how income works, how property, how income and expenses are. Assets and liabilities, how to add more into the asset column, less into the liabilities if you already work. If you are in business, how to add more to assets, get away from the expenses, how to leverage income and not expenses, taxes, income, you know, mortgage payments, and so forth. And then let me go ahead and find here. My highly educated dad recommended that I do what he did. Son, I want you to study hard, get good grades so you can find a safe, secure job with a big company and make sure it has excellent benefits. My rich dad wanted me to learn how money works so I could make it work for me. Big point, okay? Make money work for you is what I want to tell you. Develop assets, develop passive income, develop things that are going to be cash flow, that are going to make you income, money that's going to come into your pocket, not out of your pocket. You might think that an asset is an asset, but it's not. It falls into the liability column. A house is a liability. All these different things where you're paying people to finance your house, you're paying people to take care of your finances. It might be an expense and an asset to you, but it's really a liability. and so thinking about it differently. And he goes into this in detail, goes into the charts, why they don't teach you financial literacy in school, how you should learn it, why you should learn it, how it's going to pay dividends in your life. And it has, for me, not ever having to think about doing something like this, to actually putting in the time to think about it and going through it. It's going to help you increase your awareness. It's going to sharpen up your mind. And when you hear these things, when you see these things, you're going to make better decisions in your life. You're not going to get comfortable with what's in front of you. You're going to start over. You're going to start overachieving. You're going to start seeing these things, how they impact your life. And it's true that education does not stop after school. And a lot of people, when they go to school, maybe they go get a PhD, they go further on in their studies, and then they stop. And then there's people who teach you entrepreneurship or teach you business in school who have not done it themselves. But I went to school and I learned it. What gives you the right if you haven't done it yourself? And that's what Robert talks a lot here, who he had a friend, you know, who tried to teach entrepreneurship. And, you know, all meanwhile, they were struggling themselves to understand that concept of, they didn't go to school. They went to school to learn it, but they didn't, you know, understand how to do business themselves. So that's one way that Robert goes about it. And then, you know, this really transformed my life. I started a business before reading this, but this only gave me more help with it. This will be down below in the description if you're watching this on YouTube, or if you're in my blog post, how you can get it, and how I recommend every person has this. It's life transformational. It turned my business around, really helped me earn more money in the process of it. And it just gave me a more helping hand in everything that I'm doing nowadays. And I can't thank this book enough among many that I've read. This is one of the biggest books here that you're ever going to read, and I guarantee that. So Rich Dad, Poor Dad, take a look at that. There'll be more information down below. And, you know, it's very inexpensive, $3 to $5 or more or less. All right, guys, that's my review on Rich Dad, Poor Dad. You know, wherever you want to get to, personal finances, personal development, this will really help you out in both ways. It's going to help you transform into the person you really want to be.